Hello, and welcome back to my playthrough of Doctor Who, The Edge of Reality. In the last episode, the Tenth Doctor was brought into play, although we didn't get to see him on the TV screen, sadly, due to a glitch. And we also came across the Cybermen, which was more scary than I thought it would be. We saw the Cyber Warship, and we did something to it. I think we blew it up. And now the TARDIS has brought me to a brand new location. And in today's episode, we'll find out what that is. And hopefully, we'll see the 10th Doctor face to face. Without further ado, let's get into it. So let's see where the TARDIS has brought us. This looks like Mars. 22nd century. I think we've got ice warriors to come. Ah, it's him!
Daleks, weeping angels, Tasma, Cybermats, the first, and the Cyber Reaper. You didn't think I was going to sit this one out, did you? Seriously? Allons-y.
Oh, like my God, it's the Doctor. I am absolutely going to chase after him. Let me be your companion, please.
Don't forget, we need to track down and destroy the force field units so the Doctor can get the TARDIS here.
Oh, look at him. And he's wearing his blue suit as well. Which I always have loved.
Was that giant statue facing this way a minute ago?
Probably, but I don't care about that at the moment. I just want to follow my boy, the Doctor.
Don't give up now.
Keep going, Doctor. We'll catch up.
I'm right behind you. There's no catching up I need to do. This is like a fanboy or fangirl running after David Tennant. Just being right on his heels. I'm not even paying attention to all the creatures that are materialising. Oh, I love the Doctor, the 10th Doctor. There he is! Yeah, I should probably help him out. What? No.
Wow, the time-space continuum packs quite a punch.
Oh, okay, I did survive it.
Another weak spot in reality. The next transmitter must be near.
Allons-y.
Right behind you, Doctor.
The lighting is a bit weird for this place.
That sculpture isn't native to Mars, is it?
I don't know if it's deliberately meant to be quite, I don't know the word for it, like washed out.
You're almost there.
But it just feels like, I don't know, it shouldn't look like this. No, the Doctor's gone.
We're on our own now.
Oh, this is sad. Okay, let's go up here. And act like I know what I'm doing, but I really don't.
Some of this orbiting wreckage is passing pretty close. Hitch a ride.
I can't jump. So, how am I going to get across? Oh, hello! Oh, you flip off. And again. There's the one I need to stand on. Go! Up! Maybe not. Oh, hello. Do I jump off?
Can you jump onto that curve, please?
Well, it's a bit late now. Oh, this curved piece. There we go.
Use the sonic to take out the power source of the reality virus.
Right. No idea where this is. Oh, okay.
More chaos. The virus is unraveling causality. Not a sentence I thought I'd be saying today.
No idea where I'm going. This Cyber Reaper is absolutely going to kill me. Yep, I will be. I'm probably missing lots of collectibles, but I honestly don't care at the moment.
Even the laws of physics are breaking down.
I just want to get the hell out of here. Nah.
Careful. Some of these objects are unstable.
And I did the opposite of what she said. Just hope that these don't phase out of reality.
Watch your footing.
I will try
to fix you.
Oh, not a dead end. Oh dear.
I don't know about you, but this is making my brain itch.
Yeah, mine too. But I haven't died too many times, which is good. But I'm speaking too soon. Oh, hello, are you right behind me now?
Yes, the doctor's here.
Don't try anything, or it will kill you. The Cyber Reaper. At last, the ultimate warrior. Pitiless, relentless, devastating. Not as tall as you look on telly. Go on then, let's have it. The bit where you lay it on thick with a bit of cyber gloating. You know, it's weird. For a race that's got no emotion, it feels like you lot love rubbing it in when you think you've got the upper hand. All that you will be deleted stuff. Why don't you ever just crack on with it?
We understand the value of fear.
To humans?
To Cybermen.
After all these years, after all these battles, after all these defeats, for you, that is, not me, you still don't get it. Emotions aren't how we live, they're why we live.
After all these years, after all these battles, after all the losses of loved ones, for you, not us, you do not understand.
Understand what?
Your lack of emotion is your greatest strength, Doctor. That single fact is why I recognized the value of upgrading.
To what?
To you.
No.
You are the ultimate warrior. Pitiless, relentless, devastating.
Is that what you think?
You reconfigure your friends, strip away their safety, and harvest their strengths. You upgrade them to soldiers. You have one goal, victory. And your reluctance to acknowledge the rights of your enemies is...
Is what exactly?
Logical. You will break the transmitter to destroy our virus?
Yeah. Natural reality will snap back into place and order will be restored. Job done.
You would eradicate the new realities created by the virus?
Where are you going with this?
You must choose. victory or kindness. You must decide whether you have a warrior's heart.
Or?
A compassionate heart. In one reality, you encountered a human known as Renette.
Madame de Pompadour. Yes.
You felt love for this human.
Love is not a weakness.
And you lost her. But in this new reality, he stayed with her. They developed a family unit.
They are kids.
You are the ultimate warrior. Pitiless, relentless, devastating.
Stop it. Stop this.
Oh. Well, this is pretty. So, it seems the 10th Doctor...
2 minutes to lash up a video recorder out of an astrolab and some psychic paper. Mm. You're losing your touch, Doctor.
Oh, is he on that screen? Anyway, as I was saying, it seems in this reality, the 10th Doctor stayed with Renette, which is quite sweet, and they had a family.
No one's called me the Doctor for years. And that's fine, I used to love it though. Swaggering in somewhere, I'm the Doctor, this is Romana, Susan, Jamie or Sarah, or Adric. No, not all good memories.
Oh, I'm really liking this. The music's beautiful, the environment's beautiful. I'm hearing David Tennant's beautiful voice. This is so relaxing in comparison to what I've just been through. What's that green
Sometimes,
screen?
When I'm sitting with your mum, she asks me, where have you gone? And it'll be Scarra, or Gallifrey, Unit HQ. But I just shrug and say, nowhere, I was just thinking about it. Because I know she feels guilty. Even though I've told her a million times that this little house, with you lot in it, means more to me than everything out there put together. Our home is so much bigger on the inside.
I'm actually welling up a bit. This is lovely. As I said in the previous video, I'm so glad that David Tennant returned to voice his character. This is literally like a dream come true, having David Tennant in a Doctor Who video game. This may not be perfect. There are... oh dear. There are a few glitches here and there. And the graphics of the character models... well, it's mainly the Doctor. The graphics of the Doctor could be a bit better. But this is still a really enjoyable experience. Right, let's go up as quickly as possible because I want to hear more of David Tennant's lovely voice.
Anyway, I am leaving you this message in case anything happens to me. I want you to look after your mum. When you're old enough, she'll tell you stories of scary clockwork monsters who came to get her. A fireplace that could take you to the stars. Before it broke. And a man from another world who rode to her rescue on a big white horse. Yeah, maybe she'll share the stories that I told her. About people made of steel and cities made of song. She still thinks I regret losing all that, but she's so wrong. The truth is, I thought when I settled down with her that I was giving up the universe, but I was wrong. She was giving me the world. Don't let her forget that. Mm-hmm.
she took her lonely angel and made him better. Maybe she should be called the Doctor. Let's face it, like I said, no one's called me the Doctor for years, and that's fine. Because, well, I'd prefer Dad these days.
I almost don't want to fix reality in a way. I want to give the 10th Doctor his happy ending. I can't believe I'm getting so emotional at this. I think it's the music more than anything. The music of all three of these games is extraordinary. Oh, I don't want to leave. I want to stay here and hear about the... Oh dear! Okay, I can stay here for a bit longer. Yeah, I wanted to stay here and hear more about what the 10th Doctor got up to and the life he lived. But I think the game wants me to leave, so I have to do that.
Seen enough.
In this reality, the Doctor and his family live tiny lives. They are made happy by acts of irrelevance. You are on record as claiming, but for some people, small, beautiful events are what life is all about. You would destroy that.
It's a bit of a shame that the subtitles don't match up with what's actually being said.
All these years, I've thought you had one purpose. To destroy the enemies of the Cybermen. But that's not quite it. Your one mission is to find those enemies.
And nullify their threat.
And you've done it. I can't make this choice. So you've got to. You're the Doctor now.
Let's end this. It all depends on you now. One last transmitter. Run for it!
What, is the game almost over? I thought there would be loads more additional levels. Just got a trophy saying some days no one dies at all. So maybe I got that because the Cyber Reaper hasn't killed me in a while.
Hiya, come in. I just wanted to thank you for, you know, saving the universe. After you zapped the final transmitter, the virus was destroyed and reality reasserted itself. For better or for worse. Hey, you're probably wondering where Emma is. Emma, can you hear us okay?
Loud and clear, Doctor. Loving your old TARDIS. What is it with you and hexagonal decorations?
How's the new body?
Amazing!
Give us a tick. I kept my word. Downloaded Emma into a synthetic body so she can move about. Feel, taste, take part, do all the things we sometimes take for granted. Only problem was, after all the adventures she had gallivanting about with you, she wanted more of the same. So I took a few temporal liberties and sent her back in time. Yeah! She's gonna go traveling with someone I think you know. Actually, he can tell you himself. Left a message. I'll patch it through.
It's gonna be the 10th Doctor, isn't
Hello.
It? Hello!
I just wanted to say thanks. I understand you had a very difficult decision to make and you didn't shirk it. Good work, shirk.
Come on, Doctor.
Her ladyship won't tell me what the decision was about. But maybe I can guess. Hard sometimes, isn't it?
Get a move on.
Emma told me she's going to share some information, though, that I can pass on to you in the laundrette or something. Anyway, better get going. Emma wants to find out what it's like to live, so I promised I'd show her around the universe. And you know what? I really want to go.
Nice little reference to David Tennant's final line, he said, in both his regeneration episode and the 50th anniversary special.
We've landed. The TARDIS has brought us home. Recognise this place? Go on. Take a look.
Let me guess. It's the laundrette for the third time now. Yeah.
A million years from now. Or was it last week? Reality itself was almost destroyed. It was saved by a hero, a mysterious traveller in time and space. Yeah, it was saved by you.
And that's the end. Okay. Just like with The Edge of Time, I'm a bit surprised at where it ended. I thought there'd be a couple of extra levels after the end of the Edge of Time aspect of the game. But I suppose we got the quite long Cyberman level with the cyber warship you have to explore, and that took me forever to do. I think I'll save my proper thoughts for a review type video, because I need to go back and think how I found the game overall. But I guess as a summary, I quite enjoyed it. Admittedly, it was disappointing in some aspects. I've said before about the glitches and how it's a bit of a shame that the Doctor wouldn't really appear on screen a lot of the time. But that aside, I still had a lot of fun. I think highlights were the Weeping Angel level. I found that just as scary as when I played it in The Edge of Time. The cyber warship was also fun at first, but then admittedly I did get a bit annoyed towards the end once I started struggling and not knowing where I was meant to go. And I think in terms of this episode of the playthrough, I loved that bit where the 10th Doctor is talking about the life he lived with Renette. I thought that was a really sweet part of the game. And I actually enjoyed that more than a lot of the action scenes, which was quite surprising. But anyway, that's just a summary of my thoughts. I might do a proper review over the coming days. But thank you very much for watching this video. I do hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a like, as it really does help me out a lot. And if you've played the game yourself, drop a comment down below and let me know your thoughts on it. I'd love to hear it. If you haven't bought this game, please do consider buying it. I think it's available on Steam, PlayStation, Xbox, and hopefully by the time that this video comes out, it should be available on Nintendo Switch as well. Thank you again for watching, and I will hopefully see you in a future video. Take care!